Alright, hey guys. So today I am going to show you how I install my Senegalese twists. I'm not at all like a hair expert, hair blogger, anything like that. But I basically just wanted to show other people my method, how I do it, especially as pretty much like a beginner in terms of the protective styles and installing hair and all of that good stuff. This is literally only like the third time I've ever done twists on my own hair. So there's still a lot of trial and error involved, but I just wanted to, like I said, share with you guys what some of my methods are. I didn't really do a whole lot to prep my hair. I have really kinky type 4 hair, as most of you probably know if you've already like seen my blog or my IG. I just did a regular wash and condition prior to. I trimmed the edges of my hair. I always detangle into 4 sections, so I did that. I put in a kind of chunky twist, slept over it overnight, and it was probably about 85-90% dry when I woke up in the morning, and I just kind of took the blow dryer to stretch it and get that last 10-15% dry. I did use, I didn't show this in the rest of the video, but I did use Gabrielle Union's blow dry cream, which I highly, highly recommend if you ever blow dry your hair for any reason, whether you're blow drying it from completely wet or just a little bit cool setting, it doesn't matter. I love it because it makes your hair soft and shiny, and it just really protects it when you use heat. That was so unnecessary, I'm sorry. But yeah, this is Gabrielle Union's Flawless Collection. And so I haven't tried a lot of products from this line, but it smells amazing and it's just awesome. So that's what I used. And other than that, and it was really the only prep that I did for my own hair. I have a lot of different close-ups to show you the method. But I thought this would be cool so you all can actually kind of see in better lighting, because I had really bad lighting when I installed my hair. But so I'm going to not hold you all any longer and we'll get to the installation. So this is what I use for my twist, the Cantu Twist and Lock Gel, and I love it because it smells just like their leave-in conditioners. Cantu is a really great affordable brand. And it has that thick gel texture that keeps your twists together. I like this a lot better than the mango line that a lot of people use because it's blue and it stains your fingers a lot. The first thing I do in the installation is I part my hair. So I section to top and bottom halves. And I like to make this particular part neat so when I do the top knot, it's clean and my hair lies a little bit flatter. So the style looks better. And once I've done this, I give myself a nice middle part and then a side part on the left side of my hair, all for styling purposes. The next thing that you're going to do at this point is cut your braiding hair. So I always just cut in half right where the rubber band was out of the package, and then I use each half to its full length to actually install each twist. That's how I get the nice length that you saw in the beginning of the video. After this, you want to go across the bottom of your hair about an inch up, and that gives you your first section that you're going to start braiding with. And then I just kind of go in like 1-inch sections across the back from this point. And that's what you should look like at the beginning of your installation. I'm going to cut forward really quick and I'm going to show you how far I got after the first 2 hours. I was basically about halfway. I was moving pretty fast. And that's what it looks like. So I'm going to give you an up close tutorial on my braiding method, and then I'll show you what it looks like in the front. So we're just going to pretend that this is my scalp and the section of hair. Alright, so this is going to represent my scalp, like my head, and this is going to represent, or would be like the braiding hair. So let's say this is the hair we would use. So of course, as we know, a braid is made up of 3 components, and you continually rotate the outer alternating outer sides of the braid over the middle area. So we're going to recreate that here. So what I do is I take the braiding here and I stick it underneath the section of my own natural hair all the way up to my scalp. So we can start really big at the top. And so I hold it like this. And then I take that left outer side and I fold it over the middle, over my natural hair. Just like this. OK. Okay, so now we've got these three pieces. Then I take the right outer side of the braiding here, and I turn that over. So we've got three pieces this way, right? And then to get my hair back in the middle, I take my natural hair over in the middle. Again, make that as tight as possible. So now we've got this beginning of a braid, and now we have my hair back in the middle and the braiding hair on either side. At this point, I take my natural hair and I divide it into two halves like this. So now I've got two halves where I can, that are braided in to my scalp, that I can then start twisting. So I take this side and I rotate it between itself, and I twist it over, take this, twist it, and you'll just keep doing that, rotating and twisting, rotating and twisting, just doing it kind of loose here, but of course you would do it tight, rotating and twisting, so on and so forth, and this is how you would have your Senegalese twist. So at this point, I have dipped my ends in hot water to seal them. You just saw where I just clipped a couple of extra pieces. And then what I'm going to do here is just seal this style with some mousse. This is just Argan oil, cream of nature mousse. And I basically just apply it and pat it into my hair from top to bottom. And it just gives it some extra shine and kind of helps to seal the twists as they are. I use hairspray as well too if I'm going out.
But yeah, so this is my hair. I'm happy with it. I'm happy with the length. I'm happy with the color. It's kind of like almost like a dirty blonde, really dark brown, light brown, reddish tone even in here. So yeah, it is fantastic. So you can see I didn't do like a lot of really tiny parts in my hair, by any means. I just kind of, did like normal parts, but I thought it would be cool for you all to actually kind of see it in person. A few of these I need to kind of, you know, get the edges together a little bit, but for the most part, as you can see, yeah, it's awesome. I love it.